What's going on, guys? Tyson Anderson, Mr. Hammerdown. Listen, we're up here in Marinette, Wisconsin. Mr. Dave Miller, Miller Creek Kennels. With over 40 years of legal knowledge and legal wisdom, we're going to see if we can't run us a few hounds. Stay tuned, you guys. Stay tuned. Miller there into the 40 acre enclosure we go.
And Melody wasn't doing a whole lot at the time. And anyway, after she turned three,
I shut the back.
Boy, you're gonna get
it? Yeah,
this clothes are really easy. Oh,
right here. Push
down.
That's what I thought.
Yeah. Ugh.
Yeah.
that, but I mean, it was way cheaper than buying that commercial one. Anyway, he made me that one. Pulleys with a V belt, and that slips. You know, you hit in something kind of thick, and then it'll start slipping and smoking. And so, I went down. I ordered new pulleys in a timing belt type setup, and so that'll be a way more positive drive.
Oh yeah. Now you built this tower. You had this tower built like y'all did this.
We built it by hand. Off ladder. I had no lift.
You can't do anything with you guys. Man.
I had no lift. We just worked off the ladder. Now this here was all covered up with netting. And what happened here was I had a big heavy sticky snow that was just too much for it. It pulled the walls in. It dropped the netting, and so I got kind of a mess here now. But I just left the netting like this so that the owls can't pick off rabbits.
Oh, I got you. That makes sense.
And that's what the netting was for, was just to keep the protect the rabbits that would come in here. This is the only place I feed. I used to have feeders spread around the different areas. I gotta see what the hell's going on here. Rabbits did this, sir.
Man, this is a.
I got some other kind of animal in here.
This is a wicked little setup right here, I tell you.
Yeah, there's a electric fence all around the outside, about 4 inches from the top, and then again about 4 inches from the ground. But right now I have a broken wire out there, and I haven't had the time to get in there and fix it. And so I could have anything in here. It could be a cat in here. It could be a raccoon or. But anyway, yeah, that's what could have knocked us over. But
So who do you say you have out here running right now? You have how many dogs out here?
I got five. I got three field champions and two pups that are probably about 8 months old, 9 months old. They're out of Thea and Kizzle.
Gotcha.
Beautiful pups.
One thing I can say about him, he throws some good pups. Good looking dogs for sure.
Yeah, he does. Some guys say that they're not fast enough. And what I usually tell them is that you guys give up on them too quick. When they are 2 years old and even up to 3 years old, they find another gear and they are plenty fast. Whew. Been up here in a while.
This is crazy.
Yeah, like I said, it was like a bunch of schoolboys building a fort when we were building this thing. And I was thinking, I want to have heat in here so I can sit up here in the winter. So, what am I going to do? I thought I could get a little wood burner with a chimney. Little stove, but I gotta haul wood up. And melody yet. Oh no! I think that might be Thea, the old girl. He is pretty much a black and tan, but so is Lacey. Come on, figure him out. So, out of here, and as far as the, like the mosquitoes, they rarely come up this high, you know, so.
Isn't that something?
I've got screens for all these windows, but I've never put them in, and I've had this up here for quite a long time. Oh, there's one of the dogs over there.
Uh-huh, I think I see all of them right there.
Okay.
Now, how long have they been down?
I think about 12:30. A little after 12. But you see that PVC right there?
Uh-huh, yes sir.
Okay, there's one in the center.
Oh, that's where you're talking about the mattress can get in, yeah.
And that's 6-inch heavy wall. So, oh, look at that one snuck underneath. Oh, okay.
Good thing you seen that, right?
Yep, I saw that. And I'm gonna go make sure I get her back out of there. There, two of the Melody and Lacey, I've caught them in here, and I've Lacey, hey! And I put collars on them, and I got one of them safe things that you put.
Yeah. 10 years old.
Yeah. She'll get with it pretty good. I mean, I run her, I try and get her in here once a week at least, you know, just to keep my field champions in shape so that they don't have a hard time when it comes to helping.
Wow. Yeah, yeah.
I've had guys come, like when I had Izzo here for a while, and a guy from the west end of the UP called Arnold and wanted to breed to Izzo, and Arnold told him, he says, well, he's with Dave Miller, and he said he's breeding some of his bitches with him, and he says, I'll call Dave and see if he'll, you know, take care, handle your bitch, and we'll get her bred for you. So he called me, and I said, sure, certainly. You were nice enough to let me take them. I'll do whatever I can to get you to get a bread and get you your stud feed. And Arnold always was a guy that you don't pay him nothing until you get your pups on the ground, you know. And because one guy said, you should pay me right away. And I said, well, why? And he says, well, he did his job. You know, he bred her. And I says, well, at this point, we each got a dog that had a nice time together.
That's it.
I said, if I don't get any puppies, it don't mean shit to me. Nothing. And anyway, he insisted that I pay him. And I did, but I never dealt with that guy again.
I wouldn't have either.
And it turned out.
There goes a rabbit.
Oh, okay. It turned out I got one puppy, and that was it.
They're right behind them too.
Real sickly puppy. It was what?
They're right behind them too. That puppy.
Oh, okay.
That pup that came up at the top right there. That rabbit crossed right there. That pup probably went about 5 feet high and then double back and came right. He's right there on it. He just didn't open up.
Okay.
He's a little high right there, but
yeah, he's the puppy is probably a little bit unsure of itself.
Yeah.
It'll come pretty quick. One of the old dogs will come and open up on it, and a couple will know.
You know, I tell people that too.
Yeah.
They get so caught up, man, and trying to hurry up and get this and that and blah blah blah. And I'm like, listen, man, you gotta understand. Time and patience is the only two things. It doesn't matter how well the dog is bred, how much natural talent he's got or she's got. If you don't have patience and you don't give that dog time to mature,
exactly.
I've seen a lot of people get rid of dogs. Different. They
oh,
are.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
You can make the same cross.
I've known quite a few people that they bring them a certain place. They figure at 5 months they should be ready to start. And they'll bring them to a puppy starter, and if they don't start in that week that they're with that puppy, they get rid of them.
Yeah.
And I think, holy Christ, what a stupid way to think about
it. And they go to somewhere else.
Because I was a member of a small pack option club out of Suamico, and I they asked me to judge and volunteer to judge, and I said, yeah, okay, it's my club. And so I judged derby trial. So all them dogs are, you know, if they're under two, And some of them are a little over one only, you know, so there's usually a big difference in the pack, you know, as to talent, you know, some are just over one and some are almost 2 years old. So anyway, I judged it, and there was one dog, the other judge and I mean, we could see real early on, that's going to be.
Oh yeah. There he is. Yeah, he did, didn't he? You said it. We're not gun hunting, guys. Somebody's over there practicing shooting. Oh, yeah. I definitely love it.
Until next time, guys. Tyson Anderson. Mr. Hammerdown, we'll see ya when we see ya.
And every time I think I smell that sweet southern rain, it takes me to a station